Hi, I'm Brian Henry, your Assistant National Fire Weather Program Manager for Predictive Services with your August fire season outlook. We're now in our peak, but let's take a quick look back at July to show you how things progressed as we begin to enter our peak. Up in Alaska, they had a very active fire season, burning more than 2.3 million acres as a combination of sustained periods of convective activity with storms and lightning, combined with historic heat waves that produced all-time record heat across the state. As we enter August, things are beginning to wind down up in Alaska as the onset of the late summer rains are beginning to be felt across the state. Looking in the lower 48, things were a little quieter in July than was typical. Fire activity was average to below average in most areas except across the southwest, where they were average to slightly above average due to a late arrival of the monsoon. As we moved through July, the fuels became drier and became more receptive to fire activity as they cured out in the middle to lower elevations. Heading into August, we're basically set for the peak of the fire season. The grasses in those middle to lower elevations are now fully cured and receptive to fire activity. In the higher terrain, however, there's still a lot of greenness up there. Mountain snowpack has now come off in most locations, but it's going to take a little while for those to come into play. The outlook for the west heading into this peak of the fire season is for above normal fire potential across those middle and lower elevations across California, portions of Oregon, and portions of Washington State. Elsewhere, we're expecting near average conditions, and also up in the higher terrain, we're expecting near average conditions, except across the Northern Sierra, where it may be below average in some locations due to the residual effects of the late season moisture. As we head into September and October, we traditionally have a season-ending type of precipitation event, or at least an event that slows things down, or a series of events. And given the ongoing El Nino conditions in the Pacific, we think that'll be the case again this year. So we look for a pretty active August and first half of September across the west. Looking towards the east, we're expecting average conditions there as well. While there is some drought showing up on the drought monitor across portions of the Carolinas, Georgia, and Alabama, it's not sufficient enough to be a major concern. Also, we are seeing some periodic precipitation events there that are keeping the fire activity in check. Heading to from mid-September into October, the West generally transitions out of their fire season, except for in California, there's just a little bit of a lull, but then the fall fire season kicks in when you start having those east wind events like the Santa Ana's kicking in October and November. We are expecting an active season from that this year, as the weather patterns should line up to produce those offshore wind events that they traditionally produce most years. So due to the heavy fuel loading in those states, we expect for the fire potential to remain elevated in those areas through October and into November before that season comes to an end. As we enter November across the remainder of the country, most of the country, if not all the country except for the southeast, will be out of fire season come November. However, the southeast tends to have a late fall fire season, and they will experience some fire activity in those areas across the southeast that are experiencing drought currently, but we're not expecting anything that is above normal from a potential standpoint.